Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Hero to Superhero. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series Angular Zero to Hero in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I am going to explain about ng content, ng template and ng container. Let's start. I have created an Angular application in which I have app component and a child component. In child component, I just have a title div, and in app component, I have added the child component. And so we can see this. We know that if we need to send some data from parent component to child component, we can use @inputDecorator. But assume if I need to inject some HTML from parent component to child component, we cannot do it using @inputDecorator. For that purpose, we can use ng-content. In app component, in between these tags, we can add some HTML codes. That means we are injecting some code from parent component to child component. But this will not be visible in parent and child components. I can use ng content directive to show the injected content in the child component. So when I add ng content directive in child component, we can see the code we injected. In case we need to project multiple contents, we can add a dummy attribute or a dummy class, and we can use select property to show the specific contents. This is how we can use ng content to project a content. Next, let's see about ng container. Let me have a numbers array in which I have numbers from 1 to 8. I can use ng for to loop through this array and display inside each div. Now, if I want to show only even numbers, there are different ways available. Assume I need to use an ng if. I cannot use ng if in the same div, because in Angular, we cannot have multiple structural directives in a single DOM. So I can use a div or span or paragraph tag inside and use ngif. Like this. Now we can see only the even numbers. But assume I have given a CSS specific to div, span and p tags. Usually we will not give it like this. But to explain, let me give. Now we can see our numbers also getting this style. So instead of using a span, we can use ng container. So this is how we can use ng container to group elements. Those do not interfere with styles or layout because Angular does not put that in the DOM. Next, let's see about ng template. Ng template is a template element that Angular uses with structural directives like ng if, ng for, etc. When I add a ng template, it will not render the contents. But when I add a ng if like this, it will show. One thing to note here is, when we use ng template, we should not use the star ng if syntax. When we use star, we are informing Angular to transform that into ng template with ng if like this. That is why we are not able to use multiple structural directives in a single DOM. We normally use ng template to achieve else condition when we use ng if. Let me show an example. So here, when the condition is true, it goes inside if block and shows this text. When the condition is false, it displays the else block. This is how we can use ng template. Hope you understood and like this video. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.